And that led us into our first night safari. James is sitting in the catbird seat there, and Dee is acting as his driver. And as we were moving along and talking, we would occasionally spot things. The first thing that we saw was a spring hare, which is not a hare, nor is it a rabbit. But it is a rodent. And in addition to that, we saw an actual hare, a bush hare. This is an actual hare and not a rabbit. And Dee knew the difference between rabbits and hares. Among other things, hares, when they're born, do have fur, whereas rabbits are naked and blind. While we were moving along, I was telling Dee and James that my primary target was pangolin, and then after that, aardvark, and finally, white rhino. And almost immediately, Dee spotted an aardvark. But this aardvark spotted us as soon as we spotted it, and it ducked into its burrow, and we never got any chance to get any camera footage. So this brings up the question, what is an aardvark?
Hello there. Let me introduce myself. I'm an aardvark. I eat ants for a living. I'm a functional creation. Check the profile. That's a profile. And the mouth. Ever see a mouth like that? To show you how it works. Just suppose an ant was hiding down behind that hill. Fish free! I'm an anteater, not a fish eater.
Well, let's try for something a little more accurate.
The aardvark differs from the anteater, sloth, armadillo, and all other mammals. It is the only member of the order Dubulidae dentata, tubule-toothed, so named because of a permanent set of 20 teeth that have tubular pulp cavities extending through them from top to bottom. The teeth are rootless. Dutch farmers who first encountered the animal in South Africa called it an aardvark, which means earth pig in the Dutch language. It is also sometimes called the African ant bear. It looks like a giant, hump-backed rat with the head of an anteater, the nose of a pig, and the ears of a rabbit. It is unrelated, however, to any other mammal.
Now I find that bit about the tubular teeth to be really, really interesting. Whereas aardvark do have teeth at least, many other anteaters do not. For example, this is a comparison with the South American giant anteater. Among other things, it doesn't have teeth. And neither does the pangolin. The South American giant anteater, however, although it doesn't have teeth, it does have a nervous system that sort of anticipates teeth. That is, there are nerves going to each place where a tooth should be. Whereas the pangolin not only doesn't have teeth, it also doesn't have a supporting nervous system, suggesting that the teeth have been gone for some time.
Physical characteristics of aardvarks. The typical aardvark is about 7.5 feet long and weighs between 110 and 150 pounds, though the largest may weigh up to 180 pounds. It has a long, rat-like tail and a foot-long, sticky tongue that usually hangs out of its mouth. The tongue is curled like a coiled spring and is unleashed quickly as the aardvark sucks in its meal of ants or termites. It is perfectly suited for inserting into nests, and the termites adhere to the sticky surface. Adult aardvarks have 1 to 2 inch long whitish hairs growing from each nostril, and 20 teeth along the sides of the mouth, that are always growing. The nose hairs protect aardvarks from dust and dirt while they are digging. Young aardvarks have front teeth that fall out as the animals reach maturity. Aardvark teeth are unique in the animal kingdom, as they are rootless, lack dentine, and have hollow tubes running through them. Thick brown hair covers aardvark's pinkish gray skin. The hair serves to protect members of the species from insect bites. They have short, stocky legs and small feet with long, straight, very strong, blunt claws. Their front feet are 4 toes, while rear feet are 5 toes. The rear toes are webbed at the bottom. An aardvark looks like no other animal on Earth. The life cycle of aardvarks. During most of the day, aardvarks live in burrows in the ground. They live singly or in small groups. They usually come out only at night, when they begin searching for termites and ants, which are the major part of their diets. They can rip open ant and termite nests and quickly lap up the insects with their sticky tongues. Aardvarks have tremendous ability to dig burrows in the ground very quickly. One aardvark can dig much faster than several human beings armed with shovels. Their powerful front claws can tear through hard ground and mud-covered termite nests with very little difficulty. They dig like dogs, pushing dirt and mud backward under their bodies. They have a very good sense of hearing but very poor eyesight. When frightened, they usually run as quickly as possible for their burrows, but as they run, they frequently crash into trees and bushes. Sometimes they fight by using their powerful tails to hit their attackers, or by standing up on their back legs and slashing an opponent, usually a lion or a leopard, with their claws. Aardvark mothers usually give birth to only one or two offspring a year, usually in May, June, or July. They nurse their young in their burrows and spend most of the day with them, curled up in a tight circle. Aardvarks are able to dig their own burrows by time they are 6 months of age. Aardvarks were formerly classified with anteaters, sloths, and armadillos in the order Edentata, but this is no longer the case. The order under which they are now classified, Tubulidentata, is at least 60 million years old, though its origins are unknown. Evidence of fossil remains indicates that the aardvark ranged over Europe and Asia until about 5 million years ago. At that time, a close relative lived on the island of Madagascar. Today there is only one order, one family, Oikteropodidae, one genus, Oikteropus, and, remarkably, only one species, Afo, and it is exclusively African. It exists in relatively small numbers and does not respond well to captivity, but has survived in zoos for 10 years.
You might be asking yourself how we know that aardvarks go back nearly 60 million years to about the time of the dinosaurs, and the reason, or one of the reasons, is because you can find them depicted in the movie Ice Age. So now we need to find an aardvark that we can actually video. We spotted an aardvark on the top of a sand dune ridge, and he went over the edge of the ridge onto the other side, and we got out of the vehicle and went after him. And when we reached the top of the ridge, we discovered that the aardvark was immediately on the other side. We startled him, and he ran like a racehorse across the valley and over the next ridge. We, of course, followed him. It had frankly never occurred to me that aardvarks could take off and run that fast, or for that matter, that far. But on the other side of the dune, there he was, reasonably calm and continuing to feed. Aardvarks normally come out at night, but that's why we're here during the winter, because during the winter, in the late afternoon, they start coming out because the temperatures are so cool. But as soon as he caught wind of us, he was over the hill again. I've slowed down the tape here so that you can see him running up. But within minutes of scaring the dickens out of one aardvark and running him over the hill, we came upon another one and started filming him. And he was much more calm and easy to work with. I figured about this point, you're asking yourself, does this aardvark know that we're there? And there's a fair chance that he does not. First of all, aardvark cannot see well, either in day or night. They're very close to being blind. They depend a great deal on their hearing and on their ability to smell. Our big advantage right now is that the wind is in our favor. So chances are he really can't smell us. He can't smell us and he can't see us. That only leaves sound. And we're trying very, very carefully not to make any noise. Now, I figure you're probably asking yourself about now, how close are we to the aardvark? Well, watch the aardvark walk through my shadow. This next is one of those other Ard stories. This one has to do with an Ard wolf. Ard meaning earth and wolf meaning wolf. But in this case, it's actually a burrowing hyena that is insectivorous as opposed to carnivorous. And he's lying very flat on the ground in the shadows in the hopes that we don't see him. So he decides that we did see him, and as a result of that, he runs to the next shade and lies flat on the ground on the assumption that we won't see him there, even though we saw him running. Well, apparently he decided that it didn't work the second time either.
The trees are taller. It's the cold. It's a mirage.
I've always heard about one, but and only in the movies and stuff, but you never see it, like, properly.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. I have to take a picture, not that I'm going to remember exactly what the picture is about.